Se ve mis. Ajá.
¿Qué manda? Sí se ve, ¿verdad? Lo que supuestamente nos correspondía hoy, pero me voy a ir. Mucho cuidado y atención a lo que vamos a ir viendo. Puede tomarle una captura de pantalla y usted va armando su portafolio, por favor. ¿Logran ver acá? ¿Sí? Muy bien. Acá tengo las preposiciones, ¿ok? Esta es across the street, down the street, around the corner, on the left, on the right, next to the bank, between the bookstore and the bank. Ok, I'm going to show you in a few minutes at, in, on, ok? But these ones are for locations. For example, I can say, you can see this yellow arrow. You can see a couple here, I mean a man and a woman here. And this arrow means across the street. And I can tell you, I can say a sentence and apply this preposition. I can say, the red house is across the street. Now, number two, the red house is down the street. You can see this arrow here. Number three. You can tell or you can say or write the house, the red house is around the corner. Okay, this arrow means around the corner. And here, number four, you may say or write the red house is on the left. Okay, this is on the left. In here, you may say that the red house is on the right. Now, number six, the red house is next to the bank. Number seven, the red house is between the bookstore and the bank. Okay, so these are the prepositions and you can write or say sentences with these prepositions. Here we have on, but I have more about on, okay? Are you ready? Yes or no? Hello? ¿Puedo continuar?
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, guys, thank you very much. Thank you. Let me go back a little bit back, okay? I guess that I have more here. Just let me check, okay, please. Okay, let me check. Let me check first. Okay, so those are some, but I have much more. Okay. Okay. It's in number three. Okay, let me see, okay, because I have more, but they are not here right now. They don't appear here. Wait, wait, please. It's about adjectives and, okay. I guess that's going to be number four. It's going to be here in this unit, okay? Yes. Okay, ya me pasé. Ok, pero las anteriores son muy importantes y acá están las de hoy que van en esta unidad. Por favor, ponga mucho cuidado y atención. Ok, this is grammar and these are questions about time. Prepositions at and on. But here it's about time. But I have more Más adelantito vamos a ver las locations otra vez, ¿ok? For example, I have here, what time is it? It's 5:20. What time's the party? It's at 9:30. What day is the concert? It's on Saturday. When's the dance? It's at 10 o'clock. When's the dance? It's on Friday at 10 o'clock p.m. Ok, correcciones de una vez. Siempre que escribamos los meses del año y los días de la semana en inglés, se escribe con mayúscula. Por favor, esta es teoría. El curso este es de teoría, no es de práctica, que se refiere mucho a conversación y otras actividades comunicativas. Sin embargo, yo siempre les incluyo lecturas en vivo y a todo color acá, en tiempo real, y nos enfocamos mucho en gramática. El enfoque acá es de gramática, por favor. Tengo que corregir la ortografía y la puntuación. Siempre que iniciamos una oración, escribimos mayúscula. Siempre, siempre. Si no, no tenemos ese hábito, nos va a costar mucho. Y en los exámenes, cuando ya tengan clases presenciales, entonces se les va a complicar mejor desde ahorita. Entonces, acá estamos hablando de las preposiciones at and on. We have in también, ahorita lo vamos a ver. Y también se utilizan para, este es about time, pero también es for locations. Lo vamos a ver más adelantito. Entonces, what time is it? It's 5:20. What time's the party? It's at 9:30. What day is the concert? It's on Saturday. When's the dance? It's at 10 o'clock. Or it's on Friday at 10 o'clock p.m. Now, here we have contractions, right? What time is, what times, what day is, what days, when is, when's. So, here we have those prepositions. Let me show you here. I remember that I have, okay, I have more. Let me go back to this arrow and I'm going to see what we have. But we have more. Okay. You can see now here, we are still continue working with prepositions in, on, at, for dates and times. This is a summary of the lesson. So here we have again for dates and times, but they change a lot. Example, you have, when's the party? It's in January, in February, in March, in April, in May, in June, in July, in August, in September, in October, in November, in December. Commonly, we used to say in 4 months of the year. Commonly. But when we have a date here, we are going to use on. And on is very used in the days of the week. On Monday, on Tuesday, on Wednesday, on Thursday, on Friday, on Thursday, on Friday, on Saturday, on Sunday. But here they are giving us the date, the exactly date of the activity. That's why we have to write on or say on. And here, once again, they are giving us only not the month, but the exactly date that is going to be the activity. Okay, and then here we have on Tuesday, yes? And then we have it's on at noon, and it's at 8:30, okay? So these are prepositions for dates and times, and I am going to show you in a few minutes the for locations, okay? When's the party? It's in January. When's the dance? It's on January 15th. When's the dinner? It's on the 12th. What day is the meeting? It's on Tuesday. What time's the movie? It's at noon. What time's the dance? It's at 8:30. But be careful, we always say in the morning, in the evening, in the afternoon, but we have to say at night. Whenever you want to say something that is going to happen at night, you have to use at, not in, not on. It has to be with at. Only when you're going to write a story about, for example, you can start, On the night of December 15, 1960, whatever, I was walking around, whatever. If you want to write a story, yes, it's okay. But here, most of the times, at night. And here you have an example, the concerts on August 12th. Okay, let's go back to what I have here. I'm going to show you, okay, in a few minutes, those prepositions. Let's go with this one. Okay, this is the lesson that I have for today. And you may say, I know the clock. I know telling time. It's not that easy, okay? So these are the competences that you have to develop. You have 1, 2, 3. And unit 5, it says events and times. You have to confirm that you are on time. And the question, this is about vocabulary, is going to be, what time is it? Okay, it's 1 o'clock. You can see the clock. These are clock hands, okay? Las manecillas, we call them clock hands. So it's 1 o'clock. What time is it? It's 1:15. You can see the tiny, the tiny clock hand here and the long one here. So it's 1:15. Or you may say it's a quarter. It means 5, 10, and 15. 15 minutes, okay? In other words, it's a quarter after one, all right? And then you have number 3. What time is it? It's 1:20, or it's 20 after one. So you have to be careful with these two ways to tell the time. Number 4, you can see here the arrows. I mean, not the arrows, those are the clock hands. What time is it? It's 1:30, or it's half past one, okay? Or it's half after one. Either after or past is correct. So you have two ways, two forms to tell the time. Then we have 5. What time is it? It's 1:40, or it's 20 to 2. What time is it? It's 1:45, or it's 1:45. And here, you can see PM with capital letters. It's noon, okay? And this one, AM, it's midnight, okay? So you may say 8 a.m. or 8 p.m., capital letters, okay? And I am going to show you before I continue. No van a lograr escucharlo, pero pueden ver los ejemplos. Y puede leerle los labios al instructor. Okay, let's see.
It's 8:45. Stressed and unstressed words give English sentences their rhythm. Listen to the stress in this sentence. This is the rhythm of the sentence. It's 8:45. Stressed words sound stronger. Listen to the stressed words. It's 8:45. They sound longer. It's 8:45. Now listen to the unstressed words. It's 8:45. Listen to the rhythm in these sentences. It's 5 to 3. It's 10 to 7. It's 20 to 4. It's 8:45. It's 10 after 8. It's 11:15.
Okay, it was very noisy. That's what I turned up a little bit. Listen up, okay? ¿Qué idea les dan esas letras, esas palabras? No letras, las letras y, sus palabras. ¿Qué idea les da? ¿Por qué están en mayúsculas, por favor? Hola, ¿están allí o están almorzando? ¿O ya se durmieron? Hola, muchachos. Hola, ¿qué idea les da?
¿Indican hora, Miss?
Indica, sí, indica la hora, exacto. ¿Pero qué más?
¿Dónde se aplica el acento?
Muy bien. ¿Qué otra idea les da?
¿Qué hace más énfasis en esas palabras?
Muy bien, Natalie, hace más énfasis sobre esas palabras. Muy bien, ¿sabe a qué se refiere exactamente? Gracias, Natalie, gracias, muchachos. Se refiere a la fuerza de voz al pronunciar en una oración ciertas palabras. No existe la tilde ni el acento como en español. Solo existe la fuerza de voz. Por eso esas palabras aparecen con mayúsculas. Ok, dice five, no recuerdo qué otra. ¿Qué otra recuerdan? Five to three, creo yo. Entonces, si pone cuidado a esas, las van a leer ahorita, por favor. ¿Todos? Ok.
¿A micrófono abierto o cerrado, Miss?
A micrófono abierto, quiero escucharles, por favor, solo denme un segundo. Ok, uno, dos, tres, vamos.
It's five to three.
It's 10 after 8, it's a quarter to 9, it's 20 to 4, it's 10 to 7, it's 5 to 3. Ok, so la próxima la van a hacer en orden, ok, no, así como se escuchó. Parecía cuando Dios confundió en la Torre de Babel a las personas, ¿verdad? Ok, let's go with that. Now you have to listen and repeat, ok, listen up and repeat. Ok, let's repeat, please.
It's 5 to 3.
Yes.
It's 10 to 7.
It's 10 to 7.
It's 10 to 4.
It's 10 to 9.
It's
10 to 9.
It's 10 to 9.
It's 10 to 8. 10 to 11.
Okay, let's repeat after me. It's 5 to 3. Repeat.
It's 5 to 3.
5 to 3. Let's repeat all together, please. It's 5 to 3.
It's 5 to 3.
It's 5 to 3.
It's 10 to 7.
It's 10 to 7. It's 10 to 7.
24.
It's a quarter to 9. It's 10 after 8. It's a quarter to 11.
It's a quarter to 11.
Okay, very good. Okay, vamos con la primera actividad de esta tarde, por favor. Si tienen dudas, me escriben en el chat. Okay, vamos a ver este mapa que está acá. Tenemos 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24 sentences, okay? 24 times 2, how many? Those are going to be 48 sentences, okay? 48 plus, what time is it? Oh, those are going to be around, wow, I have no idea right now, but 48 plus 24? Okay, it's going to be around 60 or 70, 74, all like that. Okay, what are you going to do? This is the only exercise that you have right now. We have 30 minutes example. The first sentence that you're going to write right away is going to be, okay? Take out your notebook or Word. I don't know where you're going to work, okay? For this is going to be number one. This is a classwork. Write down classwork. And today's date is Wednesday. Okay, I'm going to write the complete. Wednesday, June the 16th. Okay, 2021, period. Wow, period. Okay, number one. You have to write, what time is it? Okay, we're going to write, what time is it in Honolulu? What time is it in Honolulu? Question mark, and the answer is going to be, it's a contracted form. It's 7:40 a.m. 7:40 a.m. or 20. What time is it in Honolulu? Okay, so that's going to be the answer. It's 7:40 a.m. or it's 8:20 o'clock. Period. So this is my first example. You have to work on number 2, 3, I mean, with all the countries and times around the world, okay? The two ways. Asking for each one, what time is it in Los Angeles? What time is it in Mexico City? What time is it in Vancouver? What time is it in Bogota? What time is it in Lima? What time is it in Santiago? All right, so that's going to be number two. Okay, what time is it? And you have to continue the same way. First, the first way and then the second one. This is very formal. And this is informal, to tell the time, okay? Take a picture of this so you can continue with your exercises, okay? Okay, you're going to work on this. Questions, please let me know. Take a picture because you're going to need it. Preguntas? Hello. ¿Ya le tomaron captura de imagen? Por favor, tómenle una captura, ¿sí? ¿Estamos listos? Muy bien. ¿Ya le tomaron la captura de imagen? Porque lo voy a dejar de presentar. ¿Estamos listos? ¿Sí?
¿Podría volver a ponerlo, Miss, por favor?
¿Verdad que no está poniendo atención? No está enfocada en la clase. Ya no, ahorita es la última vez que lo muestro, ¿sí? Por favor, debe de tomarle su captura de imagen. Porque son más de 24. Pregunta, respuesta formal e informal. O viceversa, ¿verdad? Como usted decía, ordenar sus ideas.
¿Cuánto tiempo dijo que teníamos?
Tienen media hora. ¿Ok? ¿Estamos listos? ¿Sí? ¿Puedo cerrar? Hola. ¿Sí?
Yes, teacher.
Thank you.
Sí, mira.
Muy bien. Vamos a hacer un compromiso ahorita. Por favor, van a terminar de hacer ese ejercicio todos porque es para ahorita y estamos en tiempo de clase. No me gusta que gasten sus datos. Considero mucho el bolsillo de sus papás. porque tienen que invertir en sus datos. Entonces, no me gusta, se los prometo, pero yo sé que son por la misma etapa de la adolescencia, ¿verdad? No dan ganas de nada. Y hasta se cansan también de no hacer nada los adolescentes. Yo lo comprendo perfectamente. Pero ya tienen ahí que realizar. Ya sabe que lo guarda, por favor, en su portafolio. Y nos vemos el viernes, primero Dios, ya en horario normal. Pero complete sus ejercicios. Escúcheme atentamente. Si usted no los complementa, el que pierde es usted, porque todo esto viene en su examen. Entonces, si no está practicando, ya la hora de su examen le va a costar mucho. Estamos claros en eso. Y el examen siempre es en líneas de selección múltiple de forma aleatoria.
Miss.
¿Qué manda? Dime, Dafne.
Perdone, ¿podría explicar qué era lo que teníamos que hacer, solo que no logré escuchar?
¿No estabas conectada, Dafne?
Sí, sí estaba conectada, pero la pantalla se me congeló entonces y se trabó el audio. Entonces,
por favor, muchachos, pero ¿le puede enviar a alguien la captura de pantalla del ejemplo, por favor? Y de la imagen a Dafne, por favor, ¿sí? No te preocupes, Dafne, ahorita tus compañeritos nos van a colaborar.
Gracias, Miss.
Y si no te colaboran, compartiéndote lo que hay que hacer, me avisas.
Gracias.
Está bien, pero tienes que estar enfocada en la clase ahorita, ¿ok? Bueno, entonces, por favor, jóvenes, desconéctense, no gasten sus datos. De verdad, considero mucho. Porque yo soy mamá también y se gasta mucho, ¿ok? Hasta pronto. Cuídense.
Nos va a ser
para venir una parte de esto. Entonces, de lo que estamos viendo, de hecho. Entonces, hay que practicar, por favor, y lo guardan en su portafolio.
Gracias, Miss.
Muy bien.